What do you do if you don't have enough memory for your data set? Let's go over three common solutions and the pros and cons of each. The three solutions we will cover are number one, increasing swap space, number two, reduce your data size via sampling, and number three, using unified virtual memory from NVIDIA. This is by far the easiest solution. Let's dive in. Solution one, increasing swap space. With this free command, you can see here I have 2 gigabytes of swap in my Ubuntu 24 OS. I'll try to load my 1 billion row dataset here while sharing my top output. CPU memory is here in the top progress bar. This is going to fill up in a few seconds, and then we'll see memory spill to disk or swap, and then kernel crash. Here are my notes for modifying swap space. Remember, this changes your underlying operating system. I chained the commands so I can copy and paste. I'll kill top, swap, paste my swap commands. All right, now I should have a swap space of 128 gigabytes. I'll rerun top, limited to my top process, upper M to sort by memory use, lower M to show memory and swap. I'll get that going. Now let me go ahead and run these cells again, with 128 gigabytes of swap space. Go ahead and run everything. Let me pull over the top view. All right, this time you'll see the same thing as before. Memory will fill up and it should fill up any second now. Now we will spill to disk or swap space, but the kernel won't crash because we have lots and lots of swap space. It will just be annoyingly slow. I'll speed up the video here. That took 36 seconds. It's not great. I'll inspect the data frame. This should be 1 billion rows. That looks right. Working, but slow. Trying to sample data that does not fit into memory in the first place comes with its own set of problems. If your data is in a CSV file or a relational database, you can do some pre-coding to try and get that data smaller to begin with. But if you want to do stratified sampling, which you very much should, now you have even more coding on top of that. All of this coding has to be run somewhere, and we're already resource constrained. That's how we're in this predicament in the first place, but let's give it a shot. Solution number two, we'll do sampling. We'll do a couple types of sampling here. You see here, I've got the documentation open because Pandas has a pretty nice sampling API here. So you got group by, sample. It's gonna sample from within the groups, and the groups are your strata, essentially. So right here we have group by A, and we're gonna do N equals one, but I prefer to do it more like this one where we take a fraction or a percentage of the strata, typically maybe to make sure you get the right amount of data per target. Now, if we go back over here, let's see here, open up the right tab. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and run this. Let me make sure, okay. So I'll go ahead and run this. And I'm just gonna do a simple, let me just actually do 1%, 10% is a lot. This is a billion rows. So I'll just do 10 million rows and I'll let this run. I'll pop up my top here so we can see. Now memory is gonna fill up and then it's going to use swap space to sit here and do the sampling. This is gonna take a minute. I'll go ahead and speed up the video. All right, we should be done here. There we go. All right, 2 minutes and 39 seconds. This is not great. All right, let me think about this. Okay, so 2 minutes and 39 seconds. And oddly, we're not using all of our memory. That's kind of strange. That's one of the things with swap space. We don't know what the operating system is gonna do. All right, so that is 2 minutes and 39 seconds. Well, let me just check it out here. Make sure I have 10 million. Let's see here. 1,000 million, 10 million rows. Okay, so I've got 10 million rows. That worked. It took over two and a half minutes. Okay, now we're gonna do stratified sampling. We're gonna pretend that A is our target. And again, let me do 1% here instead of 10%. All right, everything looks good. I'm gonna go ahead and restart the kernel. Let's see, memory should clear out. There it goes. All right, memory's cleared out. Let me go back. Yeah, everything looks fine. Okay, let me re-import pandas and I'll run this stratified sampling. This is going to take forever. I'm going to actually go ahead and get some stuff done and check on this periodically, and I will speed up the video because this is going to take a very, very long time. All right, 20 minutes. Wow. You can see here, right here, 20 minutes. I'll go ahead and look at it. Make sure we have, that looks good. Let's see here, 10, 2 million rows, okay. So that seems fine. Let's go ahead and do a little pretend feature engineering. Great, right? Because we're only using 1% of our data. Memory looks fine. Okay, so that is sampling. Obviously, very, very slow with swap, and we lose a lot of information from our data. So what is NVIDIA Unified Virtual Memory, or UVM? Unified Virtual Memory is a system that allows both CPUs and NVIDIA GPUs to access single shared memory address space. It automatically and transparently moves between CPU and GPU memory as needed based on where it is accessed. It leads to cleaner code as memory management and heterogeneous systems is abstracted away. And very importantly, applications can use datasets larger than GPU memory, with the system managing data movement between CPU and GPU as needed under the hood. Using unified virtual memory does not require any code changes. Swap space is turned off to prove no disk is being used. Free command shows zero. Always, always, always run the magic command load ext kudef.pandas before importing pandas to ensure GPU acceleration. I will go ahead and show the GPU memory widget from NV dashboard like this. CPU memory is empty. As this runs, GPU memory will fill up here and then spill to CPU memory, not disk or swap. You see CPU memory starting to be consumed. I'll speed up the video here. Okay, 13 seconds, way faster and way easier than using swap or sampling. Your current pandas code will work as it is written today to use this method. Just a quick side note on NV dashboard. This is one of my favorite technologies from NVIDIA. NV dashboard is a JupyterLab extension for displaying GPU usage and other profiling dashboards. It visualizes hardware metrics like within JupyterLab, like GPU compute utilization, GPU memory consumption, PCIe throughput, and NV link throughput if you have these technologies under the hood. To get started with NV dashboard, it is a simple pip install like here or conda, whatever you like. To get started right away with NVIDIA Unified Virtual Memory, you can use Google Colab or Kaggle Notebooks, as long as you make sure to use the free GPU. So we'll do that right here. I'll go to change runtime type. I'll go with the T4 and click connect. This might take a second. All right. Secondly, you have to make sure, always, always, always run this load underscore ext kudef for pandas. And that's a CUDA X libraries for data frames. That is like so. Now you have to do that before you do your import of pandas as PD. That's kind of cool. All right. So the way we know we're using unified virtual memory and also CUDA for data frames is if I look at the output here, let's see if I can zoom in here. All right. So this says fast equals kudef, and this is where we're talking about your data frame is going to be synced between the GPU here and also CPU here. If we let me actually restart this to show what it looks like without it. Let's see here, restart session. I'll say yes, and I'll add a, here we go, I'll do import pandas as PD. And this is what it normally looks like. You see module pandas and then where it's installed, but you, You have to run this before import pandas. Import pandas, PD, and see, this is how we know we're using unified virtual memory and CUDA for data frames or CUDAF. To quickly recap the three solutions, solution number one, increasing your swap space. This is not ideal. You're changing the fundamental nature of your operating system. Plus, as you perform operations on your data, you're reading and writing from disk instead of memory. This will be sluggishly slow. Solution number two, sampling. In theory, you can go as fast as you want. You can sample all the way down to just a single row of data, but you lose all the information, which might be critical for your analysis or modeling. The other problem is you have to do stratified sampling, which is even more coding and more computational resources, which you're already lacking. Solution number three, NVIDIA Unified Virtual Memory. I highly recommend starting here if you have this too much data for your memory situation. Unified virtual memory, you don't have to do anything different. The code in your pandas doesn't have to change. It comes already baked into CUDA for data frames or NVIDIA CUDAF. I hope you try it out. I hope it works out for you. And as always, cheers and happy coding.